This is the pilot vanishing point. This is the pilot vanishing point. But this is not. Let's find out what it is. So what we have here is the new Majohn A1 Capless fountain pen. If you didn't know any better, you'd swear this was a new release by Pilot and this one fell off the back of the factory door. But let's look at some similarities and some differences as well too. Overall length is pretty much on par with the Pilot. Shape of the nose cones, even with the little subtle step down, same as the Pilot as well. On the back end, we do see some subtle differences. The Pilot is a bit more rounded. The Majohn, a bit more angular and has a little groove on the side and on the end as well too. The back knock or the clicker itself, same length as well too, pretty much same diameter as well too. You will notice that this one does not have a clip. Well, this one comes in two flavors, one with a clip and one without. I decided to buy myself the one without the clip, and this may just be well the answer for people who have tried out the Pilot and did not like having the clip interfere with their grip. Well, this is the clipless model. The other difference is on the back, it has a little roll stop on the back of the barrel here. The other big difference is the center bands. The Pilot has a double band. The Majohn tries out the new stylized, striated, with a bit more angled grooved band in the middle. So let's try this out and compare it how it writes and the internals as well too compared to the Pilot. So let's ink this baby up and see what it can do. Now, ink wise, I have a few samples that I've been willing to try out. I've got the Platinum Cocky Black. That one has a bit of a green tint to it. Platinum Carbon Black, which is kind of nice. And the Platinum Black itself. So I think we will go with the Carbon Black just so it matches the gorgeous black finish on the pen. Now with the pen itself, simply unscrews apart. I'm not going to use the blank cartridge this time. I am going to use the converter. One thing to note about the converter does screw apart for maintenance and cleaning, which is great. And that simply just slides right in, snug it down, unscrew this all the way out, and we're ready to fill it up. Filling the nib unit is pretty straightforward. Just give it a little shake, your sample vial. In this case, this one fits in right here and keeps it from toppling over. Make sure the converter is screwed back out. Screw it back down all the way down. Get ready for suction. Insert it and make sure the nib is all the way submerged into the ink itself. And unscrew it up. Did we get any fill? I can't tell. Gonna try it a few more times. I'm just pumping it in and out that way. And as you can see, big problem. I don't see any ink. I don't see any ink being expelled out either. Well, the problem is the nib unit has to be submerged beyond this point in order. Otherwise, you're just drying in air, because this is the actual point where the ink actually is taken in. So I'm going to tilt this and try it again all the way down. See, right now I'm getting ink at the bottom of that section there. That's perfect. So pump it in. Do it one more time, and if you did it right, there we go. We can tell there's ink in there. Perfect. Let's tidy this up. Put this away. And put it back into the pen. It only goes in one way. And we're ready to write. So let's do a quick writing sample and see how it performs right out of the box. Actually, I did not get a box. I bought this one without the packaging and basically just came in a little sleeve, bubble wrapped. And the little box of goodies with the cartridges. So this one here is Majohn A1 Capless fountain pen. This one's the extra fine nib. Actually, the nib is pretty smooth. No issues on feedback or scratchiness at all. I'm very surprised. And the ink we're using is platinum carbon black. And as you can see, the ink holds up really well on this paper as well too. No issues at all. Just to do some quick writing. No issues at all keeping up with the ink demand. I think I kind of like the nib on this one. It's very smooth. No issues with the feed at all. Fast writing, slow writing, or so. So far, it feels great in the hand. Quality-wise, I mean, the finish is excellent. I think I don't see any issues at all. No rough spots or anything on the pen. Very smooth, even coating all the way across. I'm surprised I still have the Moonman logo on it instead of Majohn. But the clicking mechanism is solid and smooth. But I'm going to try this out for about a week or so and get back to you and see how it performs on the long run. So stay tuned. I've been using this pen continuously for 1 week now, and it sat unused for the last over 48 hours. One little side benefit, if you'll see, is that I've got a lovely black nib. Well, so far, I guess it's a side benefit, but the pen has been functioning just fine so far. If I take the nib unit out, so here's the nib unit in all its glory. As you can clearly see, the whole nib and the feed is just coated in the ink. It hasn't been leaking out of the front or anything, but I'm just perplexed why this would be happening. So right now it's been sitting over the weekend, unused since Friday afternoon, so over 48 hours, and we're going to see how it writes. And the good news is, it has no issues drying out or anything, but I'm just perplexed why this ink is all leaking out the side of the nib. So I'm going to clean this up, I'm going to re-ink it with another ink, and see if we can repeat this issue of this mysterious leakage. Stay tuned. So I cleaned everything out with warm soapy water. Everything cleaned out really nice. The front barrel, I flushed that out. Very little ink came out the front. I was expecting a whole ton of ink to be just jammed up at the front nozzle there, but nope, nothing. The cartridge converter cleaned up really nicely as well too. It does come apart for cleaning, which is bonus. And the nib unit, no issues there either. That cleaned up nicely as well too. So I'm not sure what the issue is. Maybe the issue is it does not like being filled up by dipping the nib into the ink. So what I'm going to do is take one of the empty cartridges and syringe fill that up. I'll be using Diamine's Odinil and trying that out and see if that makes any difference. So let's try that out. Pop that in, make sure it's nice and snug. Put the metal cap. And I'm actually going to leave it nib down and observe if there are any issues before I put it into the pen itself. I just want to see where this leakage is coming from and what's causing it. Well, as you can see, it's been about 15 minutes later and the ink has worked its way out, down the feed and out the nib. So far so good, so it looks promising. Let's get this out of the way and let's see how it writes so far. So far no issues with the ink coming out where it's not supposed to. So far, so the ink is flowing just right, no issues at all there. So I can't really tell why the first time we had so much ink creeping out the sides here. So let's put it back in the pen itself, and fingers crossed that the leakage does not repeat itself. As for usage so far, I have had it in constant use for about a week. No issues at all with the nib drying out. The door seals really well. I think it's pretty much just as good as Pilot does. It's a nice hefty feel. As a vanishing point user, I kind of miss the clip because I used to use that as a reference for my finger when I lined it up. Now I have to visually look to see where the roll stop is to make sure that that's actually top of the pen. The clicking mechanism has worked great. No scratches or anything appearing on the end here. So really smooth on the knock. And overall feel, no issues with scratches or, you know, scrapes or anything flaking off. So the paint quality is really well. And I'm really happy with the performance of the nib itself. Moonman, Majohn A1, Capless, extra fine, and this is Diamine Odinil. No issues at all keeping up. No skipping, no hard starts. I'm really happy with the performance of this nib unit, and surprisingly for the cost, it's a great bargain. Roughly about a quarter of the price of the Pilot itself. So long-term use, well, I'll keep using it. If any issues pop up, I'll let you know, but so far this looks to be a good everyday carry, and for that price it's a great value too. And for those people that found the clip annoying, well, this might be the solution to your capless pen needs. Cheers, folks.
Well, here we are, second time around, and as you can see from the nib unit, our leaking issue still persists. We have ink all over on the back of the feed, ink on top of the nib, and ink now creeping up over the section above the nib itself as well too. And of course, all this ink is also ending up inside the barrel, which is going to make one hell of a mess with the door flap mechanism. And this ink is basically coming out right at the joint above the nib. And I'm not sure why. Something's not sealing properly internally. And I've tried this with the converter, and I've also tried with this with the cartridge. And at this point, it's a big fail. And unfortunately, because the nib writes great. And, well, just really disappointed in this. So, well, leave it with me. I'm going to see what I can do to resolve this, because it's quite unfortunate, because I was really had high hopes for this. So I shall get back to you and see what I can do to fix this.
Well, it looks like third time's a charm. As you can see, I've been using this for about a few days, and no ink leakage. Nothing on the feed, well, slightly on the feed anyways, but nothing on the nib, and nothing all over the front section either. So what did I do to fix this? Well, I took some silicone grease, and I applied it all in that little groove right there. I made sure not to cover up that little breather hole, and that was basically it. So that's been holding back whatever ink leakage has been causing through that area there anyways. So far so good. I'm hoping this thing continues to stay like that. So let's do a few little writing samples to conclude this arduous testing of this pen, and let's go from there. Now the ink I have in here this time is Monteverde Caribbean Blue, so no issues with that ink either. As you can see on newsprint, it handles it just beautifully. Very little feathering, actually hardly any feathering, no bleed through, still smooth, nice and smooth on newsprint as well too. So no issues there. So let's just do a little writing sample on some regular paper. So this one is just my regular go-to dollar store notebook, really cheap, but the paper's been really nice to me anyways. It's pretty fairly thick as well too. I'm not sure what the weight is, but it works well for a fun pen ink. Now the pen itself, no issues at all so far. Nice smooth mechanism on and off, no problem at all. The only thing I had to get used to was not having the clip here. So the ones that are bothered by having clips, well, you may just love this pen. I just had to make sure that the little roll stop was lined up so that way I can position the pen. As you can see, no more leaks on the nib as well this time either. So let's just do a little short writing sample and conclude this long-term review. So this one is the Majohn A1 Capless and Clipless, this one too, anyways. And the ink in this one is Monteverde Caribbean Blue. Oops. B. C. And no issues at all with the laying down the ink. Nice clean lines as well too, all the way right through anyways. So there you have it. Fast writing. No issues at all.
So overall, aside from the leaking issue, I think I can finally have some solace in that this is going to serve me just fine. I'll keep an eye on the leakage, see how long the silicone grease holds up. Basically, it's a thick silicone grease I used, and I made sure not to interfere with the little breather hole on the bottom there. But other than that, I think this is a great win for the price and a great value for anyway. So as a good alternative to the Pilot Capless. So there you have it, folks. Thank you very much for staying by me.